This is a nighttime test of the new MagicShine light. Let's turn her on here. Woo-hoo! That's right. This is Drury one. Let's do this.
Thank you.
Okay, we're back in the Garagemahal. After the night test ride, this is what I had on the back, just a little LED light. Bought it at Mountain Co-op, which is like REI down in the States. Just hangs off the back of the pack, but man, that thing's kind of bright, as you can see. So it works real well if somebody's coming up behind you or you have to do a short road section and whatnot. But anyway, back in the Garagemahal, as you can see, there's a reason it's called the Garagemahal. All the toys are in here. And there we have the purple beast. Let's just come around to the side on the seat. You can see the battery unit. It's less than a pound, quite small, fits in a jacket, large jacket pocket, or in a backpack. Also works really well in a fanny pack up front if you don't want to wear a jacket and want to basically travel light. It's lithium-ion battery. Then coming over to the front of the bike, you can see the light unit. It's tiny. I just reworked a helmet mount to mount to my crossbar pad because there's too much going on there, no room to put it anywhere else. The green lights are just a battery status indicator. It goes green, blue, red, whatever, to tell you the battery level since it's not turned on. As soon as you turn it on, the colored lights go away and you get the brilliant light. And she's gonna shut down automatically, I think, at this point. Either that or it's doing weird stuff. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the test ride of Drury 1 on the Purple Beast with the new MagicShine 2200 lumen bike light. Thanks. Bye.